So far in this course, we have discussed solar cells produced from inorganic materials, such as silicon. An increasing variety of materials have found their way into the PV market over the last decades. Researchers started to investigate the use of cheap, earth-abundant and safe organic compounds that showed the photovoltaic effect as well. In this section, we will look into organic photovoltaics, or OPV, in detail. We will start with a short introduction of organic photovoltaics, followed by a detailed explanation of the different concepts related to organic photovoltaics. In this video, you will learn the basic chemistry and quantum mechanic principles underlying the organic PV technology. So, what exactly is organic PV? Organic solar cells can be defined by their absorber material, which consists of either carbon-based conductive organic polymers or organic molecules. The carbon polymers or molecules can form a cyclic structure such as phthalocyanin, a cyclic structure like P3HT, or a mixed copined structure such as PCBMC61. The various carbon structures produced different absorber materials with varying material properties. The organic solar cells can therefore be produced in a variety of colors. Other advantages of using organic semiconductor materials are the potential low cost and low temperature production and the possibility to deposit on mechanically flexible and other thin or transparent substrate. When we look into organic molecules, it's important to first understand how these molecules can be conductive in nature. We will therefore need to understand its basic chemistry. The building block of organic molecules is carbon. Carbon shares its electrons with the neighboring atoms to form bonds known as covalent bonds. We can understand this concept with the help of the electron shell configuration. Carbon is the sixth element in the periodic table, meaning that it has six positively charged protons in its nucleus. A neutral carbon atom therefore has six negatively charged electrons that revolve around the nucleus. The principles of quantum mechanics obtained by solving Schrödinger's equation shows that these electrons revolve around the central nucleus in different electron clouds known as orbitals. It is important to know that these orbitals refer to the area where an electron with a particular energy is most likely to be found. This is unlike an orbit, which has a defined radius. The characteristics of an electron are described by four different quantum numbers. These are the principal angular moment, magnetic and magnetic spin quantum numbers. First, the principal quantum number n describes an energy shell in which the electron exists. The energy shell has a number of subshells, which are described by the angular momentum quantum number L. The number of subshells is equal to its principal quantum number. For example, the second energy shell has two subshells. The first three subshells with an angular momentum number 0, 1, 2 correspond to the s, p and d orbitals. We can see that the angular momentum number defines the shape of the orbitals in each subshell. The orientation of the orbitals is further defined by the magnetic quantum number ml. We can see that there are three different orientations for the orbital in the second subshell. The magnetic quantum number ranges from minus L to plus L, including zero. This results in a maximum number of 2L plus 1 orientations per subshell. Finally, the magnetic spin quantum number describes the spin of an electron in an orbital, which can either be up or down. From these rules, we can gather that the first energy level has only one subshell with one orbital. This is known as the 1s subshell. The second energy level has two subshells, namely 2s and 2p, with the third energy level has 3s, 3p and the 3d subshells. In every shell, the s subshell has only one orbital. P has 3 orbitals with different orientations and D has 5 orbitals with different orientations. Each spatial orbital accommodates 2 electrons. Since Pauli's exclusion principle dictates that 2 electrons cannot share the same set of quantum numbers in the same system, one electron should have spin up while the other has spin down. Furthermore, every orbital within the same subshell has to be occupied by one electron of the same spin before the second electron begins to fill the orbitals. This is known as the Hund's rule of multiplicity. Using this rule, the outer shell configuration of carbon is found to be 2s2, 2p2, which should be depicted as shown here. In summary, we have introduced the organic PV technology, which has the potential to offer low-cost production and versatile application. A basic knowledge of chemistry and quantum mechanics is required to understand the working principle of a semiconductor material that consists of organic molecules rather than a semiconductor material. In the next video, we will continue with the chemical bonding of organic molecules, charge carrier transport, and the formation of energy levels in organic photovoltaic materials.